In middle school, I played lacrosse. And like most spring sports in this side of the world, the days could get really, really warm. So on an especially hot one, I decided to take my helmet off to relax and kind of take a breather to cool off. And that's when I was hit in the back of the head with a lacrosse ball cleared from a defender. I went to the doctor later that day, and turns out I had a concussion. Luckily, this has been my only instance with any head injury, but a lot of people are not as lucky. 4 to 5 million people in the world get concussions yearly, and between people ages 8 and 13, concussions have doubled in the last decade. Also in the last decade, concussions have risen 200% between people ages 14 and 19. A concussion can be caused to pretty much any hard enough impact to the head or face, but it can also be caused by a strong enough jerking of the neck. A concussion can consist of two impacts, a primary and a secondary impact. The primary impact is basically the first time the brain contacts the side of the skull. The secondary impact is when the brain rebounds back and hits the parallel side of the skull, making kind of like a pinball effect, if you will. These impacts cause contusions. And contusions are basically brain bruises. And these brain bruises, like any bruise for that matter, take time to heal. These contusions cause axons to break, right here in the neuron, you can see. And these axons carry information from one end of the neuron to the other end of the neuron to basically give information to other neurons to get a task done in your body. But if these axons break, like do in a lot of concussions, that action cannot be completed. Also, if this axon does indeed break, it releases toxins. And these toxins can kill and affect other neurons around it. So there's a plethora, a lot of different side effects you can have in a concussion. First of all, when you first get an impact, you first get a concussion, a lot of people go unconscious. Now, that's not all the time. Like, for example, when I got hit in the back of the head with a crossbow, I did not pass out, I did not go unconscious. But between the next hours and days, maybe even weeks, after your first impact happens, you can experience a ton of different side effects, such as headaches, dizziness, ringing in your ears, blurred vision, nausea, and sensitivity to bright light and loud sounds. And that last one, that's why a lot of doctors tell you not to look at screens or listen to light, to listen to loud noises while you have a concussion. So when you have a concussion, those short-term effects only stay for, well, as the name suggests, a short amount of time. But even when your doctor says you're healed from concussion, some people suffer from a thing called post-concussive syndrome. It's very rare, but it's basically when you experience side effects of concussion even after your brain is healed. Some side effects of this are chronic dizziness and chronic headaches, and also having a lot of trouble concentrating. So Ray Kennedy, he was a soccer player in the mid-1970s to the mid-1980s in England. He played for clubs like Arsenal, Liverpool, and the English national team, winning cups like the FA Cup with Arsenal and the UEFA Cup with Liverpool. He was a technical player with an amazing left-footed shot. But standing at only 5'9", he was a short little guy. But he was still known for his incredible heading ability. And sadly, in 1984, he had to end his career because of being diagnosed with Parkinson's disease. Now, the same may seem like a kind of meaningless thing to say. How does Parkinson's relate to brain injuries? Well, the thing is, Kennedy did not suffer from any specific concussion that causes Parkinson's, but his subconcussive impacts did. Subconcussive impacts are small, microconcussions that go on your brain, which never show impacts right away. But if you have enough of them, like Kennedy did for playing over 10 years and hitting so many soccer balls, that those small microconcussions amounted to the disease that ended his career. Another great example of this is Muhammad Ali. The boxer who floated like a butterfly and stung like a bee also had to end his career because of Parkinson's. But instead of headed soccer balls, it was blows to the head and face. So when we talk about concussions, and especially concussions in sports, a lot of things that people talk about, especially football. So the NFL, they have received tons of lawsuits from former players accusing them of not properly looking into concussions and how they relate to permanent brain trauma, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, and dementia. In response, the NFL made a very generous donation to the NIH. But the thing is that enough? Is that enough to actually suggest that they're doing something? In my opinion, I don't think so. But a lot of people dispute that. So it brings us to the point that if concussions are still going to happen in sports, how many is too many? So the majority of doctors and experts say once you've had 3 concussions, you're done. You should not be playing sports anymore. But realistically, it's a maximum of 3. It can be less than that. It can be a minimum of 1. Because it really depends on the severity of that concussion, and it depends on your recovery. If you have an extraordinarily slow recovery and you recover really poorly, it's going to be a lot smaller. So when we're playing sports, how can we eliminate concussions from the picture? How can we take away brain injuries from sports? And realistically, we can't at all unless we take away playing sports or modify sports. And even then, like, how would we modify football? Maybe take away tackles. How would we modify soccer? Taking away heading. But the thing is, that takes away integral parts that make our games so much fun to play and watch. So in my opinion, the best way to do this is to educate young players, is to educate them how to reduce concussions by properly heading the ball in soccer, properly checking in hockey, and properly tackling in football. And that way we can help minimize the amount of concussions that happen in this country yearly.